Hello everyone, in this video lecture, let us understand experiment 2, arithmetic instructions based programs to determine if the given number is even or odd. The problem statement is as follows. Write an ALP to find if the number stored at 50H is odd or even using 8051. So the given number is stored at memory location 50H. We need to determine if this given number is odd or even. And the output will be accordingly, the output will be 11H at memory location 60H if the number is even, and if the given number is odd, we need to store FFH at 60H. Because 8051 assembler cannot display messages, so we are using just a representation for even and odd numbers. So first let us understand how do we determine whether the given number is even or odd. Consider a 4-bit number with their positional weights 8421. If we carefully observe the even numbers 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and 12 and so on, we can understand that the least significant bit of all the even numbers is always a 0. If we carefully observe, the least significant bit of all the even numbers is 0 because all the positional weights are even numbers except the least significant bit. So when this least significant bit is 0, we don't have the odd number adding to the weight, definitely it is going to be an even number. And similarly, when we observe the least significant bit of the odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, etc., we can notice that the least significant bit of the odd number will always be a 1. So we have understood that if the least significant bit is 0, then the given number is even, and the least significant bit is odd, the given number is odd. So let's consider an 8-bit number which is stored at memory location 50H. So a number has an MSB and an LSB. Our interest is the least significant bit. So if this least significant bit is a 1, it indicates that the given number is odd. And if this least significant bit is a 0, it indicates that the given number is an even number. Let us consider an 8-bit number 83H which is stored at memory location 50H. Let's expand the A3 bits, that is we have A as 1010 and 3 as 0011. So our interest bit is the least significant bit. So when we check the least significant bit here, we find that it is 1. So a 1 in the least significant bit position indicates that the given number is an odd number. So once we determine it is an odd number, we need to store FFH at memory location 60H. And this is the program logic. So we just need to take the number, determine, check the LSB bit position, and determine if the given number is even or odd. So let's write the 8051 program for the same. So to begin, we write the first three lines of code, ORG00H, SJUMP30H and ORG30H to skip the first 30 bytes of memory location where the interrupt vector table is located. So the first task is we are going to take that given number stored at 50H into accumulator using direct addressing. So I want to copy data stored at 50H into accumulator. The instruction which does this is move A, 50H. Copy the contents from memory location 50H into accumulator. We can notice that when we do not put a hash symbol, this number will be treated as an address and the data in that address will be fetched and copied into accumulator. Next, once we have got the number in the accumulator, now we need to check the LSB. To check the LSB, we use an instruction in 8051 known as the RRC. RRC stands for rotate write through carry. So this is how it works. All the bits of the given number will be shifted or rotated one bit to the right. The least significant bit enters into the carry bit and the carry bit enters into the most significant bit and the rest of the bits are shifted one bit to the right. This is how a rotate write through carry works. Our interest is to get this LSB bit into the carry bit so that later we can check the carry flag status and determine if the given number is even or odd. So we need to move this LSB into the carry bit, and the instruction which does this is the RRCA, that is rotate right through carry. The given number is in accumulator and RRC also works with accumulator only, so RRCA. So when we do RRCA, this LSB is now moved into the carry bit. So the carry flag can be either a 0 or a 1. If it is a 0, it indicates that it is an even number, and for an even number we need to store 11H. So if it is a 1, it indicates it is an odd number and we need to store FFH. In this example, and here it is a 1, so that means we need to store FFH in memory location 60H. So this checking whether the carry bit is 0 or 1, this is done by an instruction JC. JC stands for jump if carry is equal to 1 or jump on carry. Whenever the carry bit is 1, we jump to the specified label. So what should we do at that specified label? In this case, we need to store FF at memory location 60H. So at label loop 1, we need to copy FFH, data FFH, into memory location 60H. So the instruction for that is move 60H, hash 0FFH. 60H is the destination where we need to store the result. FFH is the actual number we need to store. FF is prefixed by a 0 because any number which begins with the alphabet must be prefixed with a 0 so that the microcontroller treats it as a number and not a label. So we have done. So if the carry is set, the microcontroller control jumps to loop 1, it executes this statement. In case the carry was not 1, let's assume we've taken a 4. So LSB will be 0, so carry will be 0, so it shouldn't jump. Immediately, if it is not jumping, the next line will be storing 11H at 60H. So the instruction which does that is move 60H, hash 11H. So once we are done with this, so now the carry flag is checked. If it is 1, it stores FFH. If it is not 1, it stores 11H. But after storing 11H, it should not execute this line. It should come out of this line to the last line where we stop the execution. That is where we write here S jump here, and that is the point where we end the program. So we give an unconditional jump from here, because if we don't write any instruction here, if the number is an even number, first it will execute this line, then it will execute this line automatically. So even if the number is an even number, it will display FF for both even and odd. So to avoid that, after you have stored 11H, we need to move the control to by an unconditional jump to the stop step. So we write S jump here. So when we write S jump here, the control comes automatically to this line, skipping this line over here. So thereby we can find if the given number is even or odd. Now let's execute the same and check the result. We begin by opening the Keel Microvision software. First, we need to create a new project. So go to project, new Microvision project. Let's give a name to the project. Since we are finding even or odd, I'll give the name as odd even, and then click on save. So the project odd even is created. Now we need to select the target device. We are using the Atmel company's 8089C51. This is the 8051 microcontroller from the Atmel company. Click on OK. And then say a no to copy startup code. So now we can observe that a project named odd even is created with the target device added to it. To type the program, go to file, new, the editor window opens. Here we can type the program. Once the program is typed, we need to save the program. Click on save, and we can give the same name as the project name, or any other different name can also be given. But the extension must be .asm indicating assembly. So I've given odd even .asm, click on save. Once we save, we can observe that the color of the mnemonic and the numbers labels all change. Now this file has to be added to this target. So right click on the source group, select add existing files to group source group. The type of file must be ASM source. And now select the program that we just typed, odd even .asm, and click add and close, and then just check whether the program odd even .asm has been added. Yes, it's added. Once this is done, now we should check the program for any errors. First, translate the program. We get 0 errors and 0 warnings indicating the program is error free.
then build the program and then rebuild the program to create the object files required for execution. So once this is done, we can execute the program now. To execute, go to debug, start stop debug session, click on OK. Now we can observe the memory window opens up. In case we don't observe the memory window, go to view memory windows and you can open any one of these memory windows. So the address of interest here is 50H. 50H is an 8-bit address which is internal memory. So the letter that we need to use is D, indicating data memory, and 50H is the address of interest. The output is observed at memory location 60H. So we can open another memory window and observe the output, or we can observe it in the same memory window itself. So we can observe here we have 50 and we have 60 starting here. So this is the place where we'll give the input number and this is the place where we'll see the output result. So let's enter. So the number we had taken was A3. So double click on this, enter A3. So A3 is a odd number, and for odd number, FF is stored at memory location 60H. So the output is FF at 60H. So we can observe the 60H contents, which is 00. When we click on run, it changes to FF, indicating that the given number is an odd number. Now let's change the number to an even number and observe the result. So for that, stop the execution and reset the CPU and give a second input, let's say 84. We know 84 is an even number, and for even number we have to display 11H at 60H. So 84 is entered. Now let's run the program or click F5. Yes, we observe 11H, indicating that the given number 84 is an even number. So in this session we understood how to write the ALP to find if the given number is even or odd and check the execution of the same using Keel Microvision software. Thank you.